constantly look like I've been dragged out my own grave. Hello and welcome to a weekly vlog, cheerful start. I was just watching some YouTube. I'm sat in my coat because I'm waiting to go out, but I'm just waiting for the washing machine to finish. If anyone else's washing machine says like 2 minutes, 3 minutes. It's like waiting for an Uber and it says that, but in reality it's like 5 minutes, 6 minutes. So I'm just waiting for that. It's been on 2 minutes for a good 10. And then I am going to the shops. My eye looks funny today. I've got another eye infection on the way, most likely. Which reminds me, in this video I need to talk about my skin, which is having a bit of a wobble, I think due to coming off the pill. In fact, I'm gonna do a whole update about coming off the pill because I reckon it's been about 3 months now. So we'll talk about that possibly when I'm back. What is going on with my eye? Why do I always have something wrong with my eye? Is there something wrong with it? Yeah. It's red and looks a bit droopier than normal. Of course it does. Anyway, like I said, I've got quite the shopping list to go and collect. Juicing as a way of life, which of course it is my way of life now. I think this is my passion. It's great, but you get through a lot of veg, which is the whole point of me doing it. But my God, you don't get much juice out of a bag of spinach, is what I'll say. Mum has left, which is very sad. She needed to go back up north to her own home because she's the eternal optimist and wants to be there for all of February if and when she gets called for vaccination. So she wanted to go back today and self-isolate for 10 days so that she's ready and raring to go if she gets called, because obviously she's registered at her doctor's there and not here. So rest of this lockdown, I'm riding solo. So we'll see how we get on with that. I'm sure some mental breakdowns will be on the horizon. I'm half joking. I'm now gonna, it sounds like the washing machine sounds like it's about to take off, which normally means it's actually coming to an end. So I'm gonna go deal with that. Look at my eye in the mirror for a while and wonder what's going on here. And then I'm gonna go to the shops and maybe I'll show you what I get actually from the shops. Because I'm gonna cook myself some nice meals this weekend. Just to give myself something to do. So I'm getting some things, following recipes from a cookbook. Where else did you find a recipe? And then making them. Oh. Good morning, guys. Just did a workout, quite sweaty. Just turn the music down. And now I'm gonna make my juice. Well, I've been making it more like a smoothie because I've been putting a avocado in it. Fish avocado. For fuck's sake, just trying to latch on plant pot as usual. This is a nightmare. Got there. Yeah, I'm going to make my juice, and like I said, I've just been putting an avocado in it as well, so it's more like a smoothie recently. And then once I've got that, I'm going to come and sit and talk to you about A, something funny that happened last night, B, the pill. So guys, here, green smoothie. It's got in it, in the juicer, I do my celery, 2 apples, spinach, some kale, not very much kale because I hate kale, ginger, a cucumber, which just gets more liquid in there without adding any flavour, and then put it into the blender with an avocado. I've used a whole avocado. I have made far too much really for one person. I should probably really only need half an avocado for how much liquid I now have got, and then blend it all together with some ice as well, and it's really nice. It tastes very green, so if you don't like the flavour green is a flavour, you know what I mean, that veggie kale flavour really. If it's not for you, then you won't like it, but I don't mind it. I do need 2 apples in it though, so it's sweet enough. So yeah, just in my workout, I'm going to tell you a story about what happened last night. It was so out of sorts yesterday after mum leaving. I think he's just gotten so used to having us both here, bless him. So he was just a handful all day long. And it came to a head in the evening. I thought, right, I'm going to pour a glass of wine, read my book in the bath. I started reading The Bridge of San Luis Rey, which I've tried to read before. And now I feel like this book is not for me. I'm destined to not read this book, so I've given up on it. So I was just in the bath. You can tell where this is going, but he fell in the bath, which he's done before, scrambled to get out. Was a glass of water on the side of the bath, knocked the glass over, it smashed on the floor. So I jumped up thinking, shit, he's gonna jump out of the bath and cut his paws on the glass.
Dropped her book in the bath as I jumped up. That's just floating there. Grab him. I jump out the bath. I stand on some glass. And I had got a new bath mat. Because mine was just really gross. So I was just bleeding all over the bath mat. I'm stood dripping wet, stark naked, with him wrapped up in a towel with a cut foot, thinking, honestly, this, you, whose life is more precious here? Him, obviously. So then I had to clean that up, which took forever as well. Dry him off, get him settled again. He's absolutely fine. He's forgotten about the whole thing and was sat in the empty bath already this morning. Seems to have learnt no lessons from that, but that was last night. So yeah, today's Saturday, which means nothing at the moment, obviously. And I wanted to talk to you guys. I'm deliberately doing this when I'm makeup free. I'm going to turn and face the window so that I'm in lots of daylight because I'm going to talk about my skin a bit. I have stopped taking the pill for about 4 months now. No, that's a complete lie, 3 months maybe. I have got some fake tan on, which has slightly evened up my skin tone. I should have really ideally done this yesterday. So overall, since I've stopped taking it, I feel so much better on a day-to-day basis, more than I expected to. I found that before, I'm still anxious, I still have days where I'm really sad, that happens, but what I'd found before was that if I was having a bad day or was particularly anxious or upset, it would be like all the emotions at once, so that it would almost wipe a day out of just not really being able to get very much done, and I would be really upset about stuff, really anxious, really overwhelmed, and it wouldn't particularly take that much to get me to that point, if I'm honest. Whereas now what I'm finding is that if I have a day where I'm anxious, it is just anxiety, like it sits in my chest. Can feel it as a very isolated feeling. And I might be sad as well, or about something else or whatever, but it's less like this overwhelm of despair, basically, is the best way that I could describe those days. And I wasn't having them all the time, but I just have noticed how I can isolate the feeling so much more since I've stopped taking it. So that's a huge positive. I have had 2 periods, have I? Yes. They're still like nothingness, like the kind of one that, well, depends what you all experience, but the whole time that I was on the pill, I would sort of bleed for like 2 to 3 days, but not very much, and it would stop. It's still like that now, so I don't think that's evened out. The only negative is that I'm finding that my skin is flaring up for like 1 week before I'm due on, and I'm, like I said, my cycle is definitely not evened out. I've been using an app called Clue, which is really good, and you can track any symptom of any day. And it tries to work out what your cycle is, and it's just, I'm just gonna have to keep putting information into that until things even out. Obviously, I know it takes a while for all the hormones in the pill to go from you. Also, just to say again, in case you haven't seen the previous video, the only reason I've come off the pill, I'm not planning to get pregnant at all, is just because I've been on it for over 10 years, and as I was getting older, was just having this craving to actually know what my own body was like, my own cycle, how it was affecting my mood. Like I'd said about having days of really big overwhelm, like I noticed how other women around me and friends could really not blame their cycle, but attribute certain feelings that they were having to be like, I know that this is also because I'm due on my period. And I never really had that clarity, because obviously when you're on the pill, your cycle's not your own. So I was just craving that. So my skin has been breaking out quite a bit. On this side, do you guys remember when I used to always get a breakout up here? It's always on this side, down here. Last month it was higher up, this month it's here. I know wearing a mask could be contributing to this, but I do think it's mostly hormonal, because I've been wearing a mask. A woman walked right by the window and it threw me off. I've been wearing a mask, obviously, long before this, and haven't necessarily had a breakout. It's not too bad, really. It isn't bothering me that much. They're all quite relatively small. Last month they're bigger, and like, you know, you get a deeper spot that you're like, this is gonna be with me for a couple of weeks to go through its awful spot cycle. But I just thought I'd mention it and show you guys what that's looking like, because obviously this I was worried about my skin going mental from coming off the pill. But this, I feel fine about it, really. And I'm sure it will even out. So that's my update on that. I know it's something that I think is talked about a decent amount. I was really scared of coming off the pill. Like 10 years is a long, long time.
over 10 years, 12 years. I was 16 when I started taking it, I think. And yeah, I'm 28 now. And that's a really long time. And it's also all of my adult life. And I think any woman would say that, like, their cycle and that is such a big part of being a woman in terms of how it can so strongly affect people. And so it's quite scary knowing that you, something has been controlling it or masking it to a level. And then how you're going to feel after it. But overall, it's been the absolute best decision. And I'll keep updating you as we go with it. For now, I'm going to have a shower because I've been sweating. And it's a quite nice day, so I'm going to go for a walk. I'm feeling relatively upbeat today. I think because it was obviously lovely having mum here. But you know, when then you get the space to yourself and it's quite nice, but that novelty will wear off extremely quickly, I'm sure. But I feel pretty okay today. And just keeping an eye on Trouble, who has been... The same woman's just walking past. Are you lost? Where are you going? Yeah, keep an eye on him, who is an absolute handful. So I shall shower and then I'll show you what I'm wearing to go out for a walk. Drink my green smoothie. The vision of health this morning. Oh, that kale is actually coming through. It's not as nice as I was pretending it was. What's happening outside, Ouija? What's happening? Come on, let's go tell the people. What's going on outside? This way, Ouija. Well, snowing in London. Big, fat, fluffy snow. I would take him out. I have just taken him out. I would film it, but I don't trust myself to hold him with one arm and film with another. But you're very interested, aren't you? Come here. What is it? What is it, Ouija? What is that? Hey? That was a child shouting. Come on. What do you think? It's a paw on the window. Where is it coming from? Hey? Should we have a coffee? Get you a treat? I've been sick this morning, bless him. Not sure why, but it's okay now. Quick recovery, eh? What is going on? It's really coming down out there. Isn't it, Ouija? Really snowing. My goodness. Hey Google, turn the light on. It's really dark obviously because it's snowing. Just fake tanned, which I'm trying to do to make effort to feel a bit nicer. I use the Clarins Drops one. I'll link them in the description box. They're really good. And the only thing is, unless you're as fair as me, I don't think they'll make a difference to your skin. Whenever I've got a bit of a tan, if I use them, I'm already too tanned, and obviously I'm very fair. Just having my coffee. Ouija's on the bed. Can you see him just in the corner there? Yeah, he was sick this morning, and it always frightens me because anyone with pets, cats or dogs, will know the sound that they make when they're going to be sick and being sick is frightening. But he's absolutely fine now, so I think maybe we just had something he needed to throw up. Whether or not, because like I told you, he fell in the bath, and then was obsessively washing himself, and I dried him off as best I could, but he just wouldn't stop washing himself, which obviously he felt like he needed to do. So he probably ingested a bit of bubble bath, which can't have been good for you, can it, Weege? He's fine now. I thought this was a good jumper for a snow day. I just finished The Midnight Library by Matt Haig, which I bought by accident because I thought when I saw it online, I was like, oh, that's the guy who wrote The Curious Incident and The Dog in the Nighttime. Obviously, I love that book. It's not. That's Mark Haddon. And as soon as it arrived, I was like, I know you've got this wrong. But I read it anyway. It's one that everyone seems to be reading. It's really enjoyable. It's a really good book for now if you want some light escapism. It's really, really good for that. And now I think what I'm going to read, I fancy a non-fiction because I've read all fiction except one. So I'm going to read... This, which has been on my shelf for ages, The Symphony for the City of the Dead by M.T. Anderson, which is about, I think it's a poem, or no, during the Second World War, I think, in Leningrad, and I think it's a biography following a composer. I'll know more when I've read it. I've had it on my shelf for ages. It's got lots of diagrams in it, so I'm going to start that. We need to nip to the shops to get you some food. Yes, and to get some dishwasher cleaner. It's an exciting life. The music that's on the background is very lovely. It was in my last vlog and it is in my January playlist. I wanted to let you all know that this year I'm going to try and do monthly playlists so that when we're in the summer and hopefully doing things nice, we can listen to the January playlist and go, God, I was miserable when I was listening to this music. No, I'm half joking. But anyway, I have lots of people strongly associate music with memories, so I thought it'd be quite nice to have them monthly. So I've got my January one on now. And that is all I've got to tell you right at this very second. I realised I didn't show my outfit yesterday, but that's because it was incredibly dull. Today's will also be very dull. Well, this jumper's obviously far from dull. And should we just finish getting dressed, Ouija? I think the tan will have soaked in enough now. And then make some toast. And have a really lazy morning. Come and say hello. Make the bed, obviously. You're a gorgeous boy. You really have sought since Mum left, haven't you? You're looking for her. Where did that lady go? The lady went. But you've got me. He's like, please, no. Not just you. Not just you. Hey? And now biting. Anyone got any tips on how to stop a cat biting you? Let me know. The state of my... can't really see there, but I'm just constantly covered in scratch marks because of you always wanting to fight me. And how to stop it, because he's learning, aren't you? And yesterday he had a hold of my hand biting, and I was trying to pull my arm away and he kept like gripping it with his legs. The strength. I felt quite proud, actually. Going big and strong, aren't you? Yes. Hello guys, it's really nice light in here today. It's actually a beautiful day. I went for a walk. I'm just running a bath. It's the afternoon. I'm having a Monday afternoon bath. Nothing else to do. I might then go for another walk. It's a nice sunset. I don't really know, I can't decide what to do it myself. But it's lovely light. I look at things all the time. Like, oh, should I take a photo of that? But yeah, I will take a photo of that. Let's go get my phone. It's Monday afternoon. I've been working today, and now I've finished my work and I'm having a bath. Ouija's just here, aren't you? Do you want to tell everybody what you did last night? There's always something that you've got up to. Yeah, there is. Look at how he's sitting with his arms crossed. Last night I was cooking and it was quite smoky, so I had to open the kitchen window. It's not like a fully open one, it's just a little one. Somebody jumped outside into the garden. Thankfully, the security light came on, so I saw him very quickly, and you frightened yourself and you ran straight around to the back door. But it's going to start becoming difficult to keep you inside, isn't it? Because you're really wanting to explore now, but you can't go yet until you've had the snip. What did I come down for? Oh, my phone, which is upstairs anyway. Yeah, I'm just going to have my bath. And then I don't know what I'm going to do, if I'm honest. Who knows what they're doing. I am using the L'Occitane Lavender back and a bit of my fancy Suzanne Kaufman oil bath and essences. It's very lovely. It smells so good. I don't know why my hair looks like this today. Right, let's just pop you there while I take a photo. Honestly, content at the moment is a tricky game. Hi, Luigi. Hi, baby. Yes, hello. Hello. Move this teddy bear, shall we? You okay? And you're not to get in it with me today. It looks nice, but honestly, I feel like I just share this photo of like the same three or four things over and over and over, because obviously there's not very much to take a photo of except the same three or four things. I'm just trying to find a hair bobble instead of a clip. So it feels quite repetitive just taking photos at the moment, and I just sometimes think, God, with stuff like that on Instagram, is it better not to share anything for a few days rather than just sharing something for the sake of it that you've shared a thousand times before? And I never know what my opinion is on that, because yeah, I know, we just, it's really not very inspiring at the moment, is it, darling? It's not, I feel the same. Yeah.
He's just sit down on the bed. We're going for a bath, Ouija.
Are you staying here?
You gorgeous boy, aren't you? So gorgeous. So lovely. I got lots of cuddles last night from you, didn't I? I woke up and you were giving me a cuddle. It was lovely. Very lucky. I love him so much.
Right. Start this book that I was telling you about yesterday as well. Sympathy for the City of the Dead. And just chill out for a bit. Honestly, I don't feel like I'm earning the right to relax because I'm just doing so little. But anyway, here we are. Good morning, guys. It's Tuesday morning. I'm just having my morning coffee. Luigi's here, aren't you? I'm very playful this morning. I slept so bad. Look how tired I looked. I slept so badly. I don't know about you guys, but sometimes I just have nights where I wake up at like 4 a.m. is my most normal time, but actually it was 2 last night, and your brain is just like, let's think about this, let's think about that, you should change that part of your life, have you considered reframing this, do this, you shouldn't do this, you should be doing this, and it goes on and on and on and on and on, and you just can't switch it off. That was me until from 2 till 6:30 last night. Just couldn't stop thinking, and it drives me mad because the thoughts for me at that time are so clear, so drastic to whatever is going on in my life. And then in the morning I'm like, I was a bit over the top, what was that about? You don't feel that way about things. So I'm very tired, but it is now 11. I'm showered and having my coffee, like I said. Very enjoyable first sip incoming. Just about to go to the shops. I am gonna try and make, I really like TikTok for recipes and saw this like spicy noodle recipe. So I'm gonna try and make that for lunch. So I'm just gonna nip to the shops. And then also Mum sent me some more cookbooks. I've got 3 of these now called The Roasting Tin, and they're so good because you just put everything in the roasting tin and do it all in one go. And it's also really good if you live on your own because it's all then really nice the next day as well. So I'm going to make for tea, honey roasted carrots, parsnips with quinoa and rocket, but I'll probably add some chorizo into that because I've got some in the fridge. That's literally why. So I'm going to drink this coffee, go to the shops. Okay, Ouija, what are you doing? Oi, knowing me. Hello. Can you just see him there? Just was looking at my own Instagram online. So hey guys, I've got my noodles. I'm not sure how successful this has been, but it looks good. Excited. Hello guys, it's Wednesday morning. This vlog will be going up today. I'm just gonna do some cleaning because everywhere needs a tidy up really. So I'm just gonna get that done. I'm really anxious today as well, so hopefully that will help. I have been sent something most exciting though. It's balancing you on the top of an olive oil bottle today. Borough Kitchen, which is an amazing shop in Borough Market, asked if I wanted to do one of their online cookery course things, which I'm doing on Friday, which I'm so looking forward to, and they sent me some bits. Now, which this has to be one of the most exciting things I've ever been sent, and I'm not joking, because I have needed one of these for so long, and it's the kind of thing you just never, or I've just never got around to buying. But so often I'll be like cooking something, I'm like, oh God, I really need one of those pincer things, just go and order one. And then I don't. And I have been sent one, and I feel like this is definitely the highlight of the year so far for me. I know, Ouija, it's so exciting. Just ignore him. So I'm really pleased with that. It's also been sent a lovely tea towel, a silver mixing bowl, and this is the most beautiful, but frankly, nothing is more exciting than a little hint of things. This incredible mortar and pestle, which is so, so, so nice. So as I do my tidy up in here, I'm gonna find somewhere to put that. Weege, stop trying to get into a bag of litter. You've got your litter tray upstairs, Weege. You don't need to go in there, do you? That's why there's litter everywhere and it's a mess. Oh, it's very energetic this morning. So thank you, Borough Kitchen, and we'll let you guys know how I get on in the cooking class on Friday in next week's vlog. So there we go. You can just see him moving in the corner. Let's do a cleaning montage as I get this done. And you're about to jump up here and say hello. No. And then I'll check in to sign the vlog off, basically. Not really up to chatting very much more today, truth be told. So I shall leave you with some nice music and really try to be productive. Bread for you.
Trying to see through walls. Touch your head to pour your thoughts into my hand, but now I can't. Shame, isn't it strange? Isn't it strange? I am still me. You.
Really nice in here. I realised I didn't tell you how my noodles were, but what I will tell you is I'm about to make them again, which is a testament to their success. Let's do that. So in the sauce you put a tablespoon of miso paste, a tablespoon of peanut butter, a teaspoon of soy sauce, a bit of maple syrup, a tablespoon of rice vinegar, a teaspoon of chili sauce or chili oil or whatever, and a bit of a crushed up garlic clove, maybe half a clove, or depending on how garlicky you like it. and then this is your sauce. And then I'm just steaming some bok choy and then do noodles. And the TikTok said you have to keep some of the noodle water in with the noodles to emulsify all of it. I did too much noodle water yesterday, so I need to do a bit less today. But yeah, it's so simple and this is just so tasty. Just ate those in record time. Still put too much noodle water in there, but was delicious all the same. I'm gonna sign off this vlog, which I hope you've enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in the next one.